Hello everyone, welcome to Abhipedia, powered by Abhimanyu IAS. This is 14th lecture of Science and Tech Value Addition series with Dr. Vivek Rana. In this series, we are covering topics and themes which are in news and are important for UPSC prelims 2020. So the topic for today's lecture is going to be from space segment once again, and the theme which you are, the breathtaking view which you are seeing on your screen is of FAST telescope. So in this lecture, I'll be discussing what FAST telescope is, why it is in news, what are its likely application and significance, and finally a practice question as we do, because as UPSC prelims is approaching, we need to practice more and more of such questions, and so that you could get the requisite benefit from this lecture. So first of all, why this FAST telescope is in news, I'll be covering that. FAST telescope is one of the biggest ever radio telescope made on Earth. It has eclipsed the previous record holder, which was in Puerto Rico, Arecibo telescope. So this radio telescope is making headlines in January. So I'll be covering why and how is it important. So first of all, what is this FAST word in this telescope? It has nothing to do with the FASTag, which we had covered in our earlier lecture. This is a specifically a totally new theme. This FAST telescope is an acronym for 500 meter array radio spherical telescope. So once again, this acronym has its own significance. This 500 meter, which is in acronym, is the diameter of this telescope. So this major telescope is made up of over 4,450 panels, and its size has been compared equivalent to almost 30 football fields. So that's quite massive. Now, where is it located? Now, this location of this FAST telescope is in China, but it's not enough to know just that it in which country it is. You should be familiar with the exact geographical location. So it's in Guizhou province of China, and you have to understand this Guizhou is a quite marvelous place with the picturesque landscapes, and quite mountains are also located, as you could see in the last picture, in the last slide. And this place is located in southwestern China. So make sure you give a quick overview of the map and see the geographical positions as well as the locations, because at times whenever such things are in news, the place is generally asked in a map work as well. Then this telescope has been given a nickname as well. The nickname is China Sky Eye, because it's going to locate a lot of astro objects, and it's likely to make major discoveries related to origin of universe. So application is related to astro field as well as space. It is likely to collect the radio waves from various sources which are emitting such rays, and already it has detected over 102 pulsars. These pulsars, as you know, are type of neutron stars, and it has been, this is the number which it has discovered is more than collective made by Europe and US. So it shows that the technological progress of China is making headlines once again, and this is likely to make another set of discoveries related to radio waves emitting sources, and new stars or some new discoveries related to galaxies can be unveiled by this telescope. So more and more you will see this telescope making headlines, because the earlier one had a diameter of 305 meters, which was, as I have discussed, Puerto Rico Arecibo telescope. So these radio telescopes have a lot of significance, and the significance in larger context for China is twofold. The first, it makes China a stakeholder in making those discoveries, and it has entered into space race, and it will likely to enrich the China's already prosperous space program. Moreover, the place is also gaining attention because of its tourist potential. It's one of the quietest tourist places of China. Even though there is no mobile, no camera, no car policy which is going on, so because this is a project which involves scientists as well, they don't want to disturb them. But already the footfall is in thousands and it's likely to grow. And the picturesque location adds another natural beauty to the place, and so it has a double benefit for a country like China. So this is what FAST telescope is all about. Now there are certain additional themes which you should cover from this radio telescopy theme. First of all, you have to just compare it with Indian context. Does India has some good radio telescope? The answer is big yes. The GMRT telescope, which is located in Pune, which stands for Giant Meter Wave Radio Telescope, is India's radio telescope, which is making headlines. It's one of the good ground radio telescopes which we have in India. The other one we all know is in Indian Astronomical Observatory in Leh, is also doing a fine work. And make sure you just go through the list of important telescopes of India, and then specifically radio telescope, because at times the match the following or the location based question can be asked. And secondly, these ground based telescopes, apart from the ground based telescopes, countries are now targeting on space based telescopes. We have seen how NASA has progressed with Hubble, Kepler, all such missions which just keep on adding. So India has also mastered a space telescope, which is AstroSat. This AstroSat theme we had covered in our class lectures, and as well as it's given in Abhipedia resources as well. So make sure you go through the AstroSat part as well. It's India's first indigenous space telescope, and it's already has discovered few of the stars and galaxies which are quite unique. So it is likely to make more headlines as the time passes. Apart from that, you should also cover the types of star, the various stages it goes through from your solar system topic, because that's the one theme whenever telescopes are in news, they are decoding the white dwarf, red giant, supernovas, as well as the neutron star. Make sure those basic terms you have revised thoroughly, because at times a basic question can also be framed from this section. So let's practice one of the question, and this is basically the practice question has been framed just to make you aware of some major telescopes which are operating and generally have been making headlines in last 5 years. So first of all, I have just highlighted the role of the Indian telescopes in this GMRT in Pune, Giant Meter Radio Wave Telescope, as we had discussed. And another important one which you are seeing in C option is HAGR. This HAGR acronym stands for High Altitude Gamma Ray Telescope, and it's in Henley in Ladakh, which is another major telescope. The option which you are seeing in the B, Webb Telescope, the Keck Telescope, these are the major one US telescope which are making headlines. It's in Mauna Kea mountain range in Hawaii. So this is once again a correctly matched option. So since I have asked about the incorrectly one, so D option is likely to be the answer for this one. So make sure whenever some telescope is making an headline, first of all single out which country or which is the geographical location where that ground based telescope is, what are the likely theme it is covering, whether it's a radio one or whether it's fall under UV spectrum or some x-ray, whatever the theme is. And then finally, make sure you are comparing the theme with the Indian parlance, because once you cover these telescopes topic from this perspective, whatever question UPSC is likely to frame, it is likely to be in your hold. So this is all I have for the FAST telescope, and this was the FAST quick revision as well for the previous themes which we had discussed. So I'll be back soon with another science and tech value addition lecture. So keep following the various series which are going on. And for any doubts, you are most welcome to put in comment section. I hope today's session was useful. Thank you very much.